And finally, for this presentation, let's look at Allan Deviation, or ADEV. ADEV was created by Dave Allan, and it's a derivative of the time interval error. That means that we take a series of pulses, we overleave them between each other, and we ask, for every rising edge, how far away is it from what would have been a perfect waveform? So we do that over very long time periods. We build up an enormous data set, and then we do some maths to that data. And from that, we derive what's the Allan deviation measurements. In fact, Allan deviation is the log-log plot of the square root of Allan variance. And I can tell you that mathematically, this is very complicated to explain. In a short presentation like this, I'm not going to try. But if you want to, there's a link at the end of the presentation to a video where Dave Allan himself, the man in the video, in the photograph there, does explain the maths behind it, and you can see on his whiteboard the complexities that's going on here. The point about Allan deviation is it's a very clever way of removing all the instabilities of an oscillator that are caused by systematic errors such as frequency drift, temperature and aging. So when you remove all of those things, what are you left with? You're left with a noise that cannot be attributed to some external influence. And as a colleague of mine explained, the point of Allan deviation is that you can then use that figure to compare the noise of one oscillator to the noise of another, even though the two oscillators are running at different frequencies and in different environments. So it gives you a number that you can use to say this oscillator is better than this oscillator, even though the two oscillators are not comparable when you look at the data sheets. To make the measurement, you're going to need a specialized instrument or a counter. The measurement has to be made on a gap-free instrument. So it can't, on a traditional counter, if you have a gate time of 0.1 of a second, it could be that the following 0.1 of a second, then there's a small gap between those two measurement periods. And that was a bit of a no-no in Allan deviation. And in fact, there was a way mathematically to compensate for that, but that was very complex. Modern counters don't do that anymore. Most modern counters are what we call gap-free. So they're interleaving over each other. That's much easier for an Allan deviation calculation. So yeah, if you're using an older counter, just be aware of that. One other thing we would say from experience, that a lot of counters have got a noise floor of 20 picoseconds, which equates to 0.5 to the minus 11 at 1 second tau on an Allan deviation plot. So if you're looking at an Allan deviation plot and you happen to notice that at 1 second tau, it has a figure of 0.5 to the minus 11, there's a fairly reasonable chance that that's caused by the instrument rather than the oscillator. And the oscillator is in fact better than that. So that's just something to be aware of. So the plot on the bottom right there is a Allan deviation measurement taken from one of our oscillators. And this plot, as we said, is a log-log plot. So along the bottom there, we're looking at time, and we're looking at 0.1 of a second, 1 second, 10 seconds, 100 seconds, 1,000 seconds. And then the number that we're reading off on the y-axis, it doesn't really have a value that can be equated to some electrical measurable thing beyond it being a quantity that you can compare to another Allan deviation plot from another oscillator and say this one is better than that one. So very useful matrix when comparing oscillators.